The beaches here north of Liverpool are probably best known today for these Anthony Gormley statues. But 20 years ago, an amateur's discovery of footprints in the mud dating back 5,000 years put this coastline on the map as an area of some real archaeological significance. Well, now there's been a new discovery that could take Sefton right to the top of the archaeological Premier League. JC Norman turned Indiana Jones to find out more.
We don't expect to find something as nationally significant as what we have. We discovered some flints and some timbers that obviously Ron, as our contracted archaeologist, got quite excited about.
Based on the kind of evidence we have so far, it's looking somewhere around about 5,000 BC.
Wow.
Possibly 6,000.
Here in a field in Sefton on Merseyside, an archaeological dig is taking place which could turn out to be one of the most significant sites of its kind in the country. And it all came to light after work started on a nature reserve.
Lunt Meadows is a stretch of unspoiled farmland close to the River Alt near the village of Sefton. Last year, the Environment Agency, which owns the land, secured funding to restore the site to a wetland wildlife haven.
We want to build on the existing water vole population we have. We're also looking to encourage otters back to the River Alt, and because of the proximity to the Sefton coast, we're looking to attract the wintering and wading birds from there as well.
However, they always knew that the area had interested historians in the past, so they had to be vigilant in case any unusual materials were unearthed. Sure enough, this summer, while they were digging out a pond, they hit archaeological gold.
As part of the construction phase, sort of earlier this year, we discovered some flints and some timbers that obviously Ron, as our contracted archaeologist, got quite excited about. So yes, that was a bit unexpected.
I've probably been looking for this kind of site for quite a long time.
Ron Cowell couldn't believe it. After searching for 30 years, he finally had evidence of a Mesolithic settlement, the most significant site of his career.
What we're digging here is a site probably that's going to date somewhere around about 5,000 BC. Thousands of years probably before farming was introduced into Britain. So these people are hunter-gatherers, which means that they never stayed very long in any one place.
And how do you know that from what you found?
We know it from the style of the stone tools that have come from the site, because they change over time. And we also know it from the layers of soil.
I never knew how much you could learn from a metre deep cross-section of soil.
Can you see that layer there?
Yeah.
Well, that's the plough soil. So this has been ploughed up over the last 200, 300 years or whatever. But our site is way down here.
Beneath the plough line.
Yeah, so the plough has never actually cut into any of this.
To appreciate the significance of the find at Lunt requires a bit of context. The discovery of ancient footprints on nearby Formby Beach over 20 years ago added to the Sefton region's reputation in archaeological circles. These and other finds were clear evidence that Stone Age hunter-gatherers used the coast as a source of food back in the Neolithic period, around 3000 BC. However, evidence of their presence in the earlier Mesolithic period has always been more elusive. Liverpool Museum has a number of finds from across the Merseyside area, but proof of Mesolithic settlements is extremely rare.
Lunt will really take us a massive step forward, because it will give us the detailed knowledge about how these people were living, perhaps what season they were there living at Lunt. The area hopefully will become one of the most important areas in the country when people want to try and understand how these hunter-gatherer people lived.
Find the places we can go. Find the places.
The team have already calculated that the sea once reached here, 2 miles inland. And they've also found lots of stone which mysteriously originates in Derbyshire. Now it was my turn to connect with the past. Ron had found a piece of flint which was ready to be extracted. I was going to be the first person to hold it for over 7,000 years.
So I mean, go on, we'll let you take that one out.
Really?
Yeah,
oh, I'll have to lose myself. I don't feel like I've got enough training for this. Wow, look at that. And that is a tool. And is that quite typical of the kind of things that you've been finding around
here? Oh, yes, absolutely, yeah.
And how old is that?
Well, the radiocarbon dates will give us the exact date, hopefully. But based on the kind of evidence we have so far, it's looking somewhere around about 5,000 BC.
Wow.
Possibly 6,000.
By digging out a section of the soil at Lunt, the team are able to better understand the history and potential of the site.
Brilliant! This is the youngest bit at the top here, and this is the oldest bit. And this is black sand. You need to get your fingers in and feel it, and you'll feel it's quite gritty.
It's gritty, yeah.
It's black, it's really mucky looking. But that effectively is part of the habitation layer.
So this, that would have been when people were around on the site?
Yes. So, and above that, we've got a very, very dense peaty layer. And this is organic rich, lots of plant remains in it. It's going to give us an awful lot of environmental information. And then at the top, we've got a clay deposit. We've got flooding by the sea. So it's a fantastic environmental story.
So it's like almost like a snapshot of what the area has been like for thousands of years.
That's right. It's going to tell us what kind of environment the people were living in at the time of the settlement. And that's, to me, that's wonderful because that's going to tell us what they were doing in the environment, how they might be using it.
The evidence that this is an important archaeological site has gradually begun to emerge.
This one is perhaps the most unique thing that we've found so far. Which is a polished stone, and you can see the sharp edge there that's been worked by smoothing on both those edges to produce that point. This is their means of survival in a way. I mean, this is, you know, every piece of technology that we have, you know, knives, forks, axes, anything you want to do anything with that you make an implement to do it, they have to do theirs with stone.
It's hoped that Lunt Meadows could prove to be as significant as Goldcliff in the Severn Estuary, which is regarded as the best Mesolithic site in the UK. The finds there have been nothing short of astonishing.
So what are we looking at here? Because these are things that you've discovered or extracted from the location, aren't they?
Yes, there are worked flints. These are the remains of tools that they made, or heat fractured stones that they used in cooking. And there are casts of footprints here, footprints of cranes, extinct birds, footprint of a child, a young child of about 8, and some very large bones. These bones are from extinct wild cattle, and they were hunting these things and dismembering their bodies down there on the foreshore.
So are you excited about the find in Sefton as well?
Oh yes, I mean I'm really anxious that people investigate coastal archaeology until the really spectacular finds, the perfect footprint or whatever, is revealed by the natural processes of coastal erosion.
With archaeology, the work never ends. There's always something else to find, no matter what the weather. In August, Ron Cowell sent his findings to Florida for carbon dating, hoping that the results would confirm that he'd unearthed what he'd been looking for all his life, a site of major national significance.
Much of this story actually is going to come together after we've finished digging and looking for patterns and getting radiocarbon dates. That's when I hope we can say, look, we have got a pretty important site here.
Two months later, the sun is shining on Sefton and on Ron Cowell once again. The carbon dating results are back from America.
The date they've given us is 5,800 BC for part of the settlement here. So that's about 8,000 years ago, which is really great.
So it is Mesolithic, which is what you predicted. Yeah. But you've also made another discovery.
We may well have
three buildings here that could all have been in use at the same time, that could represent a large Mesolithic hunter-gatherer settlement rather than just a little temporary camp. We might have a site which would be very, very rare in this country, where several groups of families are perhaps all living on the same site in a much larger group than we might have imagined, all at the same time.
This must be the find of your career.
I think it is, yes. I mean, I was hoping that it would be one of the better finds, perhaps, because I say I'm retiring soon, and I thought, well, okay, this might be one that I can go out having felt I've accomplished something.
Lunt Meadows has now been restored to the way it looked 8,000 years ago and has the evidence to go with it. It's also a name that will now go down in UK archaeological history.
Coming up.